this video, we're talking about the Pythagorean theorem, which is a theorem that we use with right triangles to find the lengths of each of the sides of the triangle. So remember that a right triangle is a triangle where one of the angles here is 90 degrees. This theorem can only be used with right triangles, not with any other type of triangles. So it has to be a right triangle with this angle equal to 90 degrees. And what we can do with the Pythagorean theorem is, given the lengths of two sides of the triangle, we can find the third side of the triangle. The theorem tells us that a squared plus b squared equals c squared when a and b are these two sides adjacent to this 90 degree angle, and c is the hypotenuse of the triangle. So if we say that a is equal to 3 and b is equal to 4, so the length of this side, a, is 3, and the length of this side, b, is 4, how long is the hypotenuse? What's the length of the hypotenuse, c? Well, all we do is plug in our values of a and b to the Pythagorean theorem. So what we're going to get is 3 squared plus 4 squared is equal to c squared. We'll apply our exponents. 3 squared is going to be 9. 4 squared is going to be 16. And we say equals c squared. 9 plus 16 is going to be 25, equal to c squared. And now, in order to solve for c, I need to take the square root of both sides, keeping my equation balanced. On the left-hand side, I'll get positive or negative 5 as the square root of 25. And on the right-hand side, I'll get c. Now, because we're dealing with an object in physical space, we're dealing with a triangle here, a negative length, the length of negative 5 for the hypotenuse, makes no sense at all. Our triangle wouldn't even exist. So we can discount this negative length here, and we can say c is equal to 5. And that's always going to be true. Whenever you use the Pythagorean theorem to find the length of one side, you can always ignore the negative value that you get when you take the square root and just use the positive value. So with a equals 3 and b equals 4, we know that c is equal to 5. And you can do this if you have the other values too. Let's pretend, for example, that we didn't know that a was equal to 3, and instead we knew that b was equal to 4 and that c was equal to 5. In that case, we're looking to find a value of a. We just plug these into our theorem, so we'd leave a squared because that's our unknown, that's the value we don't know. We plug b equals 4 into the equation, we get plus 4 squared, and then we plug in c equals 5 and we get 5 squared. So in that case, given b and c, plug these in and we're looking for a. So we'll get a squared plus 16 is equal to 25. Subtracting 16 from both sides to get a squared by itself, we get a squared, these two cancel, and we're left with 25 minus 16 is equal to 9. Taking the square root of both sides, we get a is equal to positive or negative 3, but again, we can ignore the negative length, so we just get positive 3. And you can see that that's originally what we started with, but the point of doing this is to show you that given any two lengths, so given a and b, or given b and c, or given a and c, you can always use the Pythagorean theorem to find the length of the third side.